5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Cue music.
This is Movies First with Alex First.
An inveterate liar, con man and thug tries to fleece a widow. But there's more here than meets the eye. A crime caper and a dramatic thriller, The Good Liar stars two of the UK's best known and most beloved actors, Helen Mirren and Ian McKellen. Consummate swindler Roy Courtney, McKellen, has set his sights on his latest mark, the recently widowed Betty McLeish, Mirren, who's worth millions, and Roy means to take it all. Roy begins plying Betty with his tried and true manipulations, and Betty, who seems quite taken by him, is soon going along for the ride. But this time, what should have been a simple scam escalates into a cat-and-mouse game, with the ultimate stakes revealing more insidious deceptions that will take them both through a minefield of danger, intrigue, and betrayal. At first glance, it appears the pair, two people in search of something special, have made a genuine connection and have decided to take a chance on each other. But nothing could be further from the truth. Her grandson, Stephen, Russell Tovey, is suspicious about Roy's motives from the get-go, though that doesn't appear to dampen Betty's enthusiasm for her new suitor. Roy merely treats Stephen as a slight irritant to overcome with his attentiveness to her. The truth is, for a man who lives by his wits and can't resist the adrenaline rush of a well-executed, high-stakes con, fleecing wealthy women is something of a side hustle. He usually has more than one iron in the fire.
Movies First with Alex First.
As director Bill Condon says in his production notes for the film, The Good Liar is an intriguing look at the dark side of human nature, but often with a glimmer of macabre humour. Written by Jeffrey Hatcher, who previously collaborated with Condon on Mr. Holmes, The Good Liar is based upon a novel of the same name by Nicholas Searle. The contention is set up reasonably well, even if Betty seems too gullible to be true for an educated woman. We, not she, are immediately privy to the two sides of his character, that of a refined and considerate gentleman and a ruthless, amoral confidence trickster, and more besides. The characters around them on both sides certainly aid the sting. There are revelations aplenty as the plot evolves, just who is playing who and why. We learn more about his background and then about her circumstances. I dare say McKellen and Mirren had a lot of fun making this picture, revelling in the subterfuge, the smoke and mirrors. You could reasonably argue that by the end it became a bit preposterous, but then just think of the fun you had along the way. The Good Liar scores a 7 out of 10.
You've been listening to Movies First with Alex First. Subscribe to the full podcast at Stitcher and iTunes or your favourite podcast distributor. This has been another quality podcast production from Bytes.com.